Hi, in this training video, we're going to look at how to live stream to YouTube and then how to live stream to Facebook on Perl 2. Now you'll be doing that using an RTMP push, and we'll also be making sure that we set up the channels in Perl to use the recommended settings for YouTube and for Facebook. So let's get to it. I'll just switch views. Okay, so here you see I've already created a channel called YT Stream, and this is for my YouTube stream. And on the encoding page, you'll see the settings here. H.624 is the codec. You just want to keep hardware accelerated because that works better with Perl, and the video encoding profile, we want that to be high. When you normally create a new channel, this checkbox is selected. Use current signal resolution as frame size. You're going to want to uncheck that, and I'll tell you why. Because if your video, your input video that you're live streaming, if there's something wrong with the cable or it starts to, you know, cause problems, that could force some resolution changes, actual physical resolution changes. And you really don't want that to happen while you're live streaming. So it's much better to select a frame size. So for YouTube, we're going to go with the 1920 by 1080, which is recommended. And they also recommend the keyframe interval of 2 seconds, a frame rate of 30 frames per second, and there's a bit rate range, so we just are able to go as high as we could in that range. It's from 3 megabits to 4 megabits, 6 megabits. So I've selected 6 megabits or 6,000 kilobits. And for the audio, it's 44.1 kilohertz. We make this selection here, AAC, 44 kilohertz. Stereo and 128 kilobits per second is the audio bitrate. And of course, if you were making any changes, you just make sure you click apply. And once you have your encoding settings done, then you're going to want to go to your streaming tab for your channel, and you're going to want to create a new stream. And we're selecting RTMP push. And here's where you want to paste in your URL and the stream name from YouTube. So I'm just going to head over here to YouTube. And I already happen to have an event created on my under Creator Studio under live streaming. If I just edit that, go under ingestion settings. And here's where you can copy and paste the stream name and the primary URL. Paste it in. And the URL. I'm going to use the primary URL. There we go, and click apply. Now, because YouTube, you generally don't have a username and password, you don't have to put anything in there. And if I wanted to, I could start streaming just by clicking this button right here. Or, because I have single touch control selected here, I could also start streaming using the touch screen on Perl. And of course, when you go back to YouTube, under Live Control Room, this is where you can preview your stream once you've started the stream on Perl. So if I just click Start, now I'm going to be streaming. And I go to YouTube and select Live Control Room. I can check the status here. I can see that my status is good on the preview. And here we are. Now you can preview your stream and see that everything is good. Now you're seeing a snapshot. It's just, it's not a, there we go. It's starting to move now. And you're done. And to stop streaming, you can just click the stop back on the streaming page in the admin panel or from the touch screen on Perl. So there you have it. It was very fast to set up a YouTube stream on Perl. It doesn't take much. Just set up the encoder settings and create a new stream with as an RTMP push. So let's take a quick look now at how to create a Facebook stream. Okay, so I'm going to switch over to my Facebook stream channel that I have right here. And on the encoding page, you see this would be the default settings. So I'm going to uncheck this current signal resolution as the frame size, as I mentioned before. And Facebook is going to want to accept a 1280 by 720. And the keyframe, we're going to change that to 2 seconds. We're going to leave the frame rate at 30 frames per second. And under the bit rate, we're going to set it to 4,000 kilobits, I should say. And the audio format is going to be AAC 44.1 at 128 kilobits per second. There. Now that the encoding settings are done, let's head over to the streaming page. And we're going to want to create a new stream. And it's going to be an RTMP push. So we're ready to copy and paste in our URL and the stream name from our Facebook page. So let's go over here, and I'm going to actually, in this case, create a scheduled event. So I'm on my Facebook page, and I just, right here under video library, under the publishing tools, I'm going to click plus live. And you can see that the URL and the stream key are right here on this first page. But before I actually copy and paste that in, I'm just going to fill in some of the details, like Epiphan U, my test stream, and give it a title. Okay. Now there isn't anything under the settings that you need to set for this, but I do want to schedule. So I'm going to click on schedule. If I wanted to go live, I could have clicked go live and gone live right away, but I prefer to schedule. So here I'm going to change this to, oh, I don't know, set a time. There we go. I could upload a custom image if I wanted to as a thumbnail for this, but I think I'm happy with this. I'm going to click schedule. Great. So now that that's been scheduled, I'm just going to refresh this page. And it should show up in your video library. I'm going to click on this. And here again, you see the title and the URL and the stream key. And here's where you might also want to look at some of the advanced features that you could set. Again, your stream key is here, but we're happy. We've already set our schedule and everything. So now I'm ready to just copy and paste the server URL, and I'll go back to Perl and paste that in the admin panel. Grab the stream key. There we go. and apply. So now my stream is ready to go. All I need to do is click Start Streaming. And once I click Start Streaming on Perl, when my scheduled event, oops, I guess I should just save that to close that. When my scheduled event is ready to go live, I can watch it and be ready to stream. There we go. So now I'm seeing the preview because I've already started the stream on my Perl. And that's it. It's very simple. It's very quick and easy to do a YouTube or a Facebook stream using Perl 2. And I hope you like and subscribe to this channel if you're interested in more Epiphan U training. Bye for now.